Hi, today we are going to study HPLC. So first of all, we'll start with the principle of HPLC. HPLC is a separation technique that involves the injection of a small volume of liquid sample into a column packed with tiny particles. The particle size is around 3 to 5 micron in diameter. It is called the stationary phase, where individual components of the sample are moved down the packed column with a liquid, that is called as mobile phase, is forced through the column by high pressure delivered by a pump. These components are separated from one another by the column packing that involves various chemical and or physical interactions between their molecules and the packing particles. These separated components are detected at the exit of this column by a flow through device called detector that measures their amount. An output from this detector is called a liquid chromatogram. High performance liquid chromatography is basically a highly improved form of column liquid chromatography. Instead of a solvent being allowed to drip through a column under gravity, it is pumped through the packed column under high pressure. The principal advantages of HPLC compared to classical column chromatography are improved resolution of the separated substances, faster separation times, and the increased accuracy, precision, and sensitivity. Now we'll see the instrumentation of HPLC. It consists of solvent reservoir, pump, injector, then column, detector, and the device for data acquisition. Here in this schematic diagram, you can see the sequence of all these components of the HPLC. Solvent reservoir is used to contain the mobile phase, and the pump is used to force a liquid through the liquid chromatograph at a specific flow rate. It is expressed in milliliters per minute. Normal flow rates in HPLC are in the 1 to 2 ml per minute range. Typical pumps can reach pressures in the range of 6000 to 9000 psi. During the chromatographic experiment, a pump can deliver a constant mobile phase composition, that is called as isochromatic, or an increasing mobile phase composition, that is called gradient elution. The another component is the sample injector. The injector can be a single injection or an automated injection system. Modern injectors are based on injection valves, which allow the sample at atmospheric pressure to be transferred to the high pressure mobile phase immediately before the column inlet. Columns are usually made of polished stainless steel and are between 10 to 30 cm long and have an internal diameter of between 4 and 5 mm. They are commonly filled with a stationary phase with a particle size of 3 to 10 micrometers. Columns with internal diameters of less than 2 mm are often referred to as microbore columns. The HPLC detector located at the end of the column detects the analytes as they elute from the chromatographic column. Commonly used detectors are UV spectroscopy, fluorescence, photodiode arrow detectors, and electrochemical detectors. For data collection, generally the computer is used. The computer integrates the response of the detector to each component and places it into a chromatograph that is easy to read and interpret. Now we'll see the types of HPLC. There are basically four general types of HPLC: normal phase HPLC, reverse phase HPLC, size exclusion HPLC, and ion exchange HPLC. The normal phase HPLC, here in this method separates analytes on the basis of polarity. NP-HPLC uses polar stationary phase and non-polar mobile phase. Therefore, the stationary phase is usually silica, and typical mobile phases are hexane, methylene chloride, chloroform, diethyl ether, and mixtures of these. Polar samples are thus retained on the polar surface of the column packing longer than less polar materials. In reverse phase HPLC, the stationary phase is non-polar in nature, while the mobile phase is a polar liquid, such as mixtures of water and methanol or acetonitrile. It works on the principle of hydrophobic interactions, hence the more non-polar the material is, the longer it will be retained. In size exclusion HPLC, the column is filled with material having precisely controlled pore sizes, and the particles are separated according to its molecular size. Larger molecules are rapidly washed through the column. Smaller molecules penetrate inside the porous of the packing particles and elute later. In ion exchange HPLC, the stationary phase has an ionically charged surface of opposite charge to the sample ions. This technique is used almost exclusively with ionic or ionizable samples. The stronger the charge on the sample, the stronger it will be attracted to the ionic surface, and thus the longer it will take to elute. The mobile phase is an aqueous buffer where both pH and ionic strength are used to control elution time. Now we'll see the applications of HPLC. The information that can be obtained by HPLC includes resolution, identification, and quantification of a compound. It also aids in chemical separation and purification, quality control, testing of drugs and medicines, for example, compliance with specifications, stability studies, therapeutic monitoring, drug metabolism studies, and pharmacokinetic studies. It is especially useful in providing compound-specific assays and in the separation and control of impurities. For the assay of antibiotics and hormones to reduce dependence on biological assays. It is also used for separation of geometrical isomers and racemates. HPLC can be used in trace analysis. Trace compound is a compound that is of interest to the analyst, but its concentration is very low, usually less than 1% by weight, often parts per million or lower. Now, as we have seen the applications, why the HPLC is most widely used technique? There are several reasons, like the wide variety of packing materials allows the separation of most chemical species. The different types of detectors available permit the sensitive detection of most chemical types, and the accuracy and precision with which eluted substances may be quantified give analytical data of highest caliber. Microparticulate packing materials give excellent separation of similar substances. These short columns in routine use allow fast separations to take place, and often complete separation of complex mixtures can be achieved with a few minutes. A combination of HPLC and spectrometric techniques like IR, UV and mass spectrometry allows the almost simultaneous quantitation and identification of solutes as they elute from the column. These are the references which I have used for making this presentation. Thank you.